You might be thinking that's a pathetically small little shofar blow. I can assure you that the Almighty Elohim is not concerned with how well his second son of his holy anointing oil can blow the shofar. He is concerned that I have today's timing to do so, though. Because today's timing to do so in this video, I'm sending forth this video, is quite remarkable. Him causing me to not have the ability to blow the shofars is actually parallels the small, quiet voice manner he sent me. I think about it. Today is the 9th day of the 11th month on our Maker's Restored calendar. This 11-9 waypoint falls on December 21st on his servant Satan's calendar. Yahweh, my Elohim, brought his second Emmanuel man-child into the world on a physical plane on 11-9 on his servant Satan's calendar 57 years and 42 days ago. Paralleling all sorts of things with both numbers, actually 42, particularly with the 1260 days of his 42-month witness against you, and the different tiers of that he's woven into his end-time timeline have been remarkable. If you do the arithmetic, that means that there are 42 days right now that offset from his restored calendar and his servant Satan's calendar. The official beginning of winter is at 9:19 p.m. tonight, according to the time zone, at the place where the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel has chosen for his name to dwell. The scattered descendants of Israel are soon going to wish that you would have prayed to him in a manner that would have caused him to not cause your flight into the wilderness to be in the winter or on the Sabbath day. The manner that I am referring to is praying to him as we walk with him in his boundaries and his judgments in obedience to the testimony of his word. Instead, you have prayed to your make-believe images of him as you walk upon your own pathways, not his straight and narrow pathway. You have prayed on your own terms, not the Almighty's terms. And as a result, you are soon going to find out that he has hidden his hidden faces from you when you cry out to him and he doesn't answer. And your make-believe Elohims cannot answer because they don't have ears to hear, or eyes to see, lips to talk, etc. I believe that this soon that he's going to do to it, so that I'm referring to, is just 4 days from today on this year's blasphemous December 25th celebration of the birth of your make-believe images of his only begotten son. 7:34 a.m. on this 313th day of the Most High El's 50th year, year of the Ram's Horn release of debts, will bring forth the completion of the 649th day from his great Prince Michael, 49th day of the 490 days of his Daniel chapter 9, 7:34 a.m. waypoint of the 24th day of the first month per his Daniel chapter 10 prophecy. 313 was the day that Yahweh my Elohim caused his second son of his Zechariah 4:14 holy anointing oil to fly into Tel Aviv that night in fulfillment of his Ezekiel chapter 3 in time son of Adam prophecy. Quite remarkable. The 14 days that followed it upon my return to Greece when I was bound per that prophecy. Quite amazing. All of it is. 7:34 p.m. tonight will bring forth a 3 1/2 day period paralleling the 84 hours that I've spoken about in other prophecies of his final period of silence from his dual heavens. Paralleling 84 days and such even. I'll talk about a tier of that in a little bit as well. All quite remarkable. The 650th day will begin at this 7:34 a.m. junction in time that he set forth last year during his seventh year Sabbath on the 24th day of the first month. per Daniel chapter 10. This 650th day, December 25th waypoint, represents the 650 shekels, 600 of which were gold and 50 of silver, that his servant David paid to the man of the threshing floor for the threshing floor that Yahweh my Elohim later rose up the first two of the three houses that he has thus far caused to be built unto his name. Or may I should say the 650 shekels represents these 650 days. Same difference. These three houses that he has also caused to be destroyed parallel the three Emmanuel man-childs that he has also caused to be destroyed. The first of which was his only begotten son, the one whose blood you trampled beneath your dual feet in profaning it. Granted, he has not destroyed the second son of his Zechariah 4:14 holy anointing oil on a physical plane, and according to the testimony of his word, he's not going to do so. Quite remarkable all that he has to say about this, about me not dying, including his only begotten son, given a prophecy for this, the night before he was killed on his three tiers of praying to his father if there be any other way. Instead of causing me to die on a physical plane, he has shortened the days of afflicting you through afflicting me in your stead. If he hadn't done so, he would have been afflicting you this whole time. The testimony of his word says so. It's remarkable how much his word has to say about this in the prophecies. But you can't understand these things because you know better than the testimony of his word. And you refuse to listen to the Michael he sent to you from Greece per Daniel chapter 10, clothed in linen, girded with a golden belt, to tell you what's recorded in his scriptures of truth, just like his word says you're going to. In order to accomplish this shortening of the days, he also had to remove the Emmanuel man-child Meher Shalal Kushbash from the womb these three strokes of times. These three strokes of times are amazing. The first two of which were from the womb of the younger of the dual wives of his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy. The reason he had to remove this Emmanuel man-child from the womb is because in Isaiah chapter 6 he tells us he's going to smite you before this man-child's cord goes forth from the womb. Look up the words for yourself. Quite amazing. So he had to do something to shorten the days, and he's woven volumes of lessons in this to help him build his family in doing so. Some of which were talked about whenever he first brought forth the first 65 tier, day tier of the prophecy about this is wickedness. I'll touch on that first in a second too in a bit. This has been an amazing opera of sorts to witness. The symbolisms and the teachings that he has orchestrated through all of this has been totally remarkable to witness. Incredible. This is a drama that he is going to recount to the generations of the millennium that are going to be molded and fashioned into his image in order to become as the stars of his dual heavens. And as of the sand of the sea, as part of his eternal heritage. Have you ever wondered why it took 136 years in order for Yahweh to seal his servant Abraham that day? He did so at the same location that he later rose up the first two of his three houses. Probably don't even know these things. I mean, you might know that one, but it's just reality that that's the location that he caused the location where the filthy dome of the rock sets today to prove that he's not with that place. Why was the first of these as the stars of the dual heavens and as the sand of the sea offspring, aka Isaac, not even conceived until the 99th year of Abraham's life and the 90th year of Sarah's life? Perhaps the 99 days of his account of the flood from the time that he caused his servant Noah to let loose the second dove that brought back the olive branch, symbolic of his second olive branch. Perhaps those 99 days are a coincidence until when he opened the door of the three tiers of the boat. Oh, quite amazing. Testimony of his word is a remarkable story that's all written upon the here and the now and him building his eternal heritage to Abraham's descendants. I will tell you why these things took so long, like the 136 years for Abraham before the sealing. Not only are these things matters of prophecy that are for the here and the now, it takes time for Yahweh to mold and fashion us in his image. He has much to teach us. He removed the Emmanuel man-child Mahershala Kushbath from the womb, the third stroke, just 2 days ago. On just the fifth day that he was in the womb. And why did he do so? He did so in order to illustrate and magnify his command for us to become perfect or to become without blemish before his faces. His only begotten son even gave us this charge. You shall therefore be perfect or without blemish before your father's faces. Matthew chapter 5 verse 48. You guys must read a different book than I read. Of course you've let Saul of Tarsus, the abomination of desolation, Saul of Tarsus' doctrines trump the rest of Yahweh's word, throw it out the window. In doing so, you've thrown the baby in the manger that you're soon going to supposedly be celebrating. You've thrown him out how, with the bath waters, the waters that would have purified you. This is spoken about in other videos as well. Why did he remove this man-child, this third stroke? He did so in order... repeating myself here. The event that caused him to remove this man-child was the elder wife of the dual wives of his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy had a brief moment, a brief lapse in time where she returned to her vomit. She returned to her wickedness. The same reason that caused the substitution with the younger wife to bring forth this man-child in the beginning. These things are talked about in the earlier videos. There's a reason why his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy refers to these things as this is wickedness in relation to these dual wives of this prophecy. There is a reason why this prophecy tells us that these dual wives are journeying forth to build his house in Shinar, aka in Babylon, in the midst of Babylon. There is a reason why he tells us that they are lifting up a certain ephah, or a certain measuring instrument, tool, between his dual heavens and the earth as they do so, as they journey forth upon the dual wings of a stork. Now, you didn't watch the pickle commercials. Lazy commission for pickles know that this stork is symbolic of bringing forth children unto Yahweh. Yahweh caused that too. He causes all things. There are exceedingly many magnificent details that he has woven into this to testify to these things, all of them. If you want to hear about them, I suggest that you turn back to him from your rebellion to him so that you and your seed will live into the millennium to hear about them. It has indeed been quite the opera. There is an old saying that came from a fat lady singing at the end of an opera, which is, it's not over until the fat lady sings. This saying certainly applies to the here and the now. It does so in a couple awesome ways. Yahweh's word calls the younger of these dual wives of his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy the daughter of Tyre, or the daughter of wealth. He does so in Psalms chapter 45. When he caused his second son, his second Emmanuel man-child, to go into the tomb for 17 days, per his Isaiah chapter 22 prophecy, on account of you stealing from him, 17 days, part of his Jeremiah 32 prophecy. When he did so, when he caused me to go in the tomb, the younger of these dual wives returned to Tyre to play the whore to Yahweh. She remains there to this day. Yahweh disqualified her from bringing forth this man-child from her womb when she did so. She chose to not obey his charge to wait upon him. However, like Sarah, the elder wife chose to wait upon Yahweh, like he commands us to do at this time, specifically referring to the here and the now. Like his Mahershala Kushbaz says, I expect him any day now. I've expected him all along through these. He says that these children, that me and these offspring of his holy seed, his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed that he's bringing forth through me, are for signs and wonders for you. They are indeed a wonder. All of this has been quite amazing. The details that he has orchestrated in this to testify to these things are beyond remarkable. His Isaiah chapter 66 prophecy charges each of you, each and every one of you, to come spin around this man-child's mother and to admit your whoredoms to him, to sing to him, to come spin around her with joy, and to admit your whoredoms to him and to sing about this matter. My hope is that the younger of these dual wives will choose to do so in the coming days, just as it is my hope that the rest of you who are fat from being Abraham's obstinate descendants will do so as well. And fat you are. You are fattened for the slaughter per prophecies like his chapter 34 in time Son of Adam prophecy. You are fattened through and by the blessings that you have received on account of you being descendants of Abraham, the blessing promises, your wealth, amazing. I'm not talking about fatness on a physical plane. I'm talking about your fat, thick heads, dense. You have indeed waxed fat. Therefore, he shut your dual ears from being able to hear him and your dual eyes from being able to see him, like his Isaiah chapter 6 prophecy tells us, before he tells us he's going to send forth his holy seed at this point. You play the whore to the almighty Ael by loving and worshiping your make-believe images of him and his only begotten son. In Isaiah chapter 23, Yahweh tells us that Tyre, aka those of you that have waxed fat as a result of the wealth that you have received on account of being Abraham's descendants, that Tyre is going to sing like the whore that you are out from 70 years according to the days of one king. The one king of this prophecy is referring to David's heir, yours truly, the one that's getting ready to rule here the entire planet. Laugh all you want, getting ready to happen. These 70 years, or these 25,200 days according to the 360 days per year of the almighty Ael's perfect smooth stones, came to an end on 3/15 on his restored calendar, 2 years, 7 months, and 28 days prior to December 25th this year on his servant Satan's calendar. These 958 days since then, as of December 25th, have been exceptionally remarkable, with El Shaddai uncovering prophecy upon prophecy to his anointed to give to you, including him sending forth the Emmanuel man-child Mahershala Kushbaz in the manner that he has been in the process of doing through his four messengers of blood that were bound in the great Euphrates River for the sixth trumpet, and now even his fifth and sixth messengers of blood that he sent forth as part of this. Included in that which he has orchestrated during this time is the destruction of the third house that he has caused to be built unto his name, complete with not one stone being left upon another, although this also has more to it. He tells us that this was given his altar, that he calls his house, the boulder design of his house, in Ezekiel chapter 43. He tells us it was going to be destroyed in Isaiah chapter 27. And he's going to remove my iniquity, therefore seal me in association with it. Quite remarkable. Perhaps you ought not to have had such contempt for his day of small things, so that you would have come to his house to learn these things. If you want your dry bones to be brought back to life with his four spirits of wisdom, understanding, counsel, and knowledge, you're going to have to turn back to our Maker through that which he has restored and separate yourself to him from the that which is false, in order to become his special set-apart treasure, his special set-apart people. These 2 years, 7 months, and 28 days have brought forth three tiers of 728 waypoints that have resulted from the 14 days of his three extensions of his seven-day fall harvest feast of huts of the seventh month. Perhaps it's a coincidence that he brought forth his only begotten son through three sets of 14 generations. Three sets of 14 generations. Coupled with his three tiers of his 228 waypoints that have resulted from the 14 days of his three extensions of the 7 days of his backup feast of that which is unleavened that he has also orchestrated into the here and the now, these six tiers of 14 days have indeed testified that his hot indignation is indeed near at hand. Three tiers of 14 days is 84 days, also paralleling the 84 hours of the death of his two sons of his holy anointing oil. These things are all quite amazing. Why is he angry with you? The testimony of his word tells us why. His word tells us that it is on account of you living in utter rebellion to the word of his mouth, including the word of his mouth that is speaking to you in this video. This is Yahweh's word that's upon Zerubbabel, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says Yahweh of hosts. This one, the one speaking to you. His Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy tells us that he is going to send forth the 20 cubit by 10 cubit flying roll of the oath of his curse upon those of you who are summoning to his name falsely and stealing from him. Before he tells us this, right before he tells us about these dual wives journeying forth upon the dual wings of a stork to build his house with this certain ephod that they're lifting up between the dual heavens and the earth. I guess it's a coincidence that he starts off that prophecy in Zechariah 5 with this about the oath of his curse. His 65th day, 1129 waypoint, is 20 days from today's 119 waypoint. Remarkable, with the 20 cubit by 10 cubit. These 20 will become 10. But first, 4 days from now, we have another waypoint. 70 days prior to December 25th was 9-3 on Yahweh's restored calendar. How this waypoint ties into last year's 9-3, fourth messenger blood delivery waypoint, and 10-3, and his one king, and his 400-day and 300-day prophecies that are for the second Exodus is incredible. There are many reasons other than these 650 days and these 400 days and 430 days for why I believe that Yahweh's day of small things is going to finally come to an end on December 25th of this year. Among them is this year is 7 years from the seven laps of the shofar of the seventh day that he orchestrated on this waypoint 7 years ago. That's why I started this video with that pathetic little small quiet voice attempt to blow the shofar. This day, the seventh day of the seven laps, those 13 laps that week, during those 7 days, but the seventh day of the seventh laps was 2,556 days prior to this coming most blasphemous day of the year on his servant Satan's calendar. Strong's number 2556 means that which is leavened. You are indeed leavened. The Most High has uncovered about the three measures of leavening now. It's really amazing too. Well, the video's getting too long as it is. December 25th is indeed the most blasphemous day each year on your father Satan's calendar. Not only is this year's massive Christianity's make-believe Messiah the seventh year, it is also the eighth year from a video that was called Man's Last Christmas. At that time back then, 8 years ago, I had no idea that my father was going to shorten the days in the manner that he has through afflicting his second son in your stead. These 7 and 8 years parallel his Micah, aka his Michael 5:5 prophecy, and his Ecclesiastes 11:2 prophecy. Ecclesiastes prophecies are amazing. Ecclesiastes 11:2 is for you sustaining his anointed for these 7 and 8 years. You have failed to do so. His word indeed marks this coming December 25th waypoint. The testimony of his word has marked each and every one of the warning waypoints that he has sent me with. However, these warnings will one day come to an end. I strongly believe that 4 days from today is indeed a very, very real possibility for when they're going to do so. The testimony of his word has come together in a totally magnificent precept upon precept, precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little and there a little way to testify to this waypoint, just like the testimony of his word has done, though, with each of these warnings. Each time, though, they've increased and they've gotten closer and closer together. It's quite just like travailing, quite amazing. And so has his Emmanuel man-child, Mahershala Kushbaz prophecy testified that his timing is indeed at hand. Turn back to the Almighty Ael, so that you are not a partaker of his hot indignation. Come out from your whoredoms to him, and be his special set-apart people. Tyre will never be forgotten again. The fat lady is soon going to sing like the whore that she is. Yahweh is going to judge between the fat and between the lean, just like his Son of Adam chapter 34 prophecy tells us that he's getting ready to do.